Today we're going to talk about the MKS S-Gen L version 1.0, and we're going to talk about how to install steppers with the DRV8825. Now I want to review a couple things here. First of all, we have our X stepper port, our Y stepper port, our Z stepper port, our E0, and our E1. Now, inside here, there's a set of pins. There's three in each row, and there's four rows. And we need to know how to set that up. So now that we know there are pins, we need to know how to jump the pins correctly. So in here, this is actually a normal mode. This would be for something like the DRV8825. And as you can see, there is an M1, 2, and zero that we have to consider. Now over here they show them right here. These are the actual pins that we're going to jump. Now it says for the red cap, is not recommended to insert the jumper cap on this part of the area. Basically what they're saying is don't put a jumper on any of these right here. So what we're going to do now is we're going to actually jump the X and the Y according to that diagram. So I'm going to put two jumpers here for these pins. Then on these two pins, I'm going to do the same if I can insert it right. And then finally, I'm going to do the last two pins right here. And that's for our X configuration for our axis. Now we're going to do the Y configuration, which is over here. Then we're going to do the next one right here. And then finally, the last one, which is right over here. And that's all we have to do to set up that portion for the DRV8825 for the jumpers. So now I wanted to show you the top of the DRV8825. And one of the things I wanted to point out is I actually have a cooling set of fins right here that are on top of the DRV8825 driver chip. The other thing that's of importance is the trim pod, which is located right over here. And that's so that you can adjust the actual current that's being used by this stepper. Now, I'm not going to cover that today because they're usually pretty good about calibrating them before they leave the factory. But what I am going to show you is the underside of the chip. This is where all the magic happens. This is where they show you what the pins are. So as you can see over here, your enable pin is located where it says EN right here. Then we have over here our direction pin. This will help us locate where we're actually going to install it on the MKS S-Gen L. So now that we know where the enable pin is, which is in the upper left-hand corner, we also have to make sure that we remember that the enable pin is located here for the X, here for the Y, here for the Z, here for E0, and here for E1. But seeing how we're just doing X-axis and the Y-axis, I'm going to show you how to install this. So we're going to rotate this over into the correct position, and we're going to place it over our pins, and then we're going to apply a little bit of pressure to put it in place. Notice how the trim pod is pointing in the same direction as the power. So we know that we can do the same for this one. So you're going to insert it like so, and then apply a little bit of thumb pressure. Now I need to let you know that if you install these backwards, you can damage your board. And also, I'll be powering my board with only 12 volts for my power supply. Other people have tried 24 and had various results because fans get interesting if you're using 24 volts versus 12, but we'll go into that in future videos. In order to actually set this up to load the Marlin firmware, What we need to do is we need to attach the big side of the USB to the board over here, and the small side we need to attach to the actual computer, so you may hear a beep. Okay, the first thing that I want to show you is now that we've plugged in the drive to the computer from the MKS SGenL, you can see that there is a firmware dot cur from the last time that we loaded. I wanted to show you this because this will change. So what I want to do right now is I want to go over to my web browser and I want to do a search on marlinfw.org. And this is where we're actually going to download our firmware. So we need to use the 2.0 version in order to use it on a 32-bit board. So I'm going to click to download this. And while this is downloading, I'm going to show you some resources that are available. So down here, they have something called reporting an issue. So the cool thing about this is if you want to search on the MKS SGen L, you can see what issues may be occurring that are open issues. And this may help you if you have an issue that is not covered by this tutorial. Also, in the Marlin firmware, where we have the actual page up here, it says need to ask a question, look here first. This is a great resource. I'll click on it here so you can see. But down below, they have a bunch of different resources that you can click on for Marlin documentation. You can go to the reprap.org, and there's a lot of great answers and questions that occur there. There's forums, and then there's obviously D Marlin Discord down here. So now that you know about those, you'll know where to search for answers for questions that you may have that are outside the scope of this tutorial. So what I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to go to the downloads folder and I'm going to unzip this. So I'm going to click on extract all, then extract. And I just need to tell you that no one is paying me or sponsoring me to do this tutorial. And I purchased all the equipment with my own money. Now I will be placing Amazon affiliate links in the description. And I want to thank a bunch of users. Unfortunately, I can't thank them individually because there's so many of them now for leaving me a tip. It was greatly appreciated and helped bring more equipment so that we could do more tutorials for you. So now that this is almost done, I'm going to open up VS Code so I can show you how to actually set this up. So VS Code is actually the integrated developer environment that we're going to be using. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm actually going to show you how to actually load the environment that we're going to be working with. So now that it's unzipped, I'm going to do add folder. And what we want to do is we actually want to go to the Marlin folder in our download folder and go to the one that's unzipped and go to this point right here and then click add. This will allow us to actually do edits to our Marlin configuration for the firmware. But the first thing that we need to do once we're in here is we need to go to the Marlin folder, then we need to go to the source folder, then the core folder, then boards.h. Inside boards.h, we're going to do a search on SGen for MKS SGenL, and this will bring us to our board type, which is right here, and we're going to copy that. Next, we're going to close out of boards.h, and we're going to go and we're going to basically close these folders down and go to configuration.h. Inside configuration.h, we're going to do a search on motherboard. And as you can see, currently the motherboard is for the default RAMPS configuration. We are not using that, so we need to replace it with what we just copied. we're going to put in board underscore MKS underscore SGen underscore L. Next, we're going to search on our steppers, which is the A4988, which is not our stepper, but the reason I'm searching on it is to bring us to the default. We're actually using the DRV8825, so I'm going to copy that. But in order to actually set this up by pasting it here, we need to enable the stepper because it's currently has a comment in front of it, which means it's not usable. We're going to remove the comment for X. We're also going to do Y. We'll do Z for good practice and E0. We're not using those last two, but I just wanted to show you because that's normally what most people use. Then we're going to have to paste the stepper that we're using for the Y axis as well. So it's the DRV8825 for both of those. Then down below, we need to actually configure our default axis steps per unit. This is what the default looks like that they give us to start with. So we're going to go over to the web browser and we're going to figure out what's going on. So I'm going to do a search on RepRap calculator. And I'm going to click on the first link. And what you'll see here is actually a way to compute what you're working with. Now for the X and the Y, they're usually belt-driven systems. And they usually use a 1.8 degree of step, which gives you 200 steps per the circle revolution of the NEMA stepper driver. And it's defaulted now to 1/16th of a step. And this is used for a GT2 belt normally, and a pulley that has 8 increments around it. So right now it says 200 steps, but because we're using a 1/32nd of a step capacity for the DRV8825, we want to use all of it. So it says that it's 400. So we're going to copy that. Then we're going to go back over to VS Code, and we're going to actually paste that in over the 80 and the other 80. Now, keep in mind that you may need to actually calibrate this later on, but those are your default starting values, and I'll show you how to deal with that in future tutorials. So the next thing that we need to do is, I forgot to show you up here for after we do the motherboard, we actually need to set what's known as the serial port. So I'm going to go up to where it says motherboard, and up here, our serial port says 0. We need to change that to -1, and this is used for an alternate way of connecting. This might be used for like an LCD, but I'll cover that in future tutorials. So you may need to enable this in the future by removing the comments. So now that we're all set up here, we need to actually set up platform.io.ini because this is default for the Mega 2560 chipset. Our chipset is not the Mega 2560, and the way that we can verify what it is to go to source core boards.h, and where we picked out our board, they show right here what our chipset is, which is the LPC1768. So I'm going to copy that. Then I'm going to close out of boards.h, and I'm going to go back to platform.io.ini, and I'm going to paste that right here. Now, in order to load this, we need to actually use the platform upload. And what will occur is we'll have a build that occurs. Some people call it a compile, and then it will upload our binary file to our SD drive on the MKS SGen L. So I'm going to click on that right now, and the compile will begin. Okay, now that the compile has finished, we need to check to see if it's successful because it said one succeeded. So I'm going to scroll up, and as you can see, our chipset did succeed. So I'm going to check the SD drive on the actual MKS SGen L. And as you can see right now, the firmware has been installed for a binary. So in order to install that, what we need to do is remove the USB drive power for a second. So I'm going to unplug it for a second. Then I'm going to plug it back in. And as you can see, I've connected the actual power cable with the power out and the actual steppers. So now that that's done, we're actually going to double check to make sure that it actually loaded. So I'm going to go over here and see. And it looks like it updated to today's date. So it looks like it was successful for loading on the board. So what I'm going to do next is actually power the board or energize the system. So keep your hands away from the board once it's energized. And then I'm going to go over to Pronerphase. I have this on my desktop. This is so I can test it. So I'm going to go to the print run directory. And I'm going to open up Pronerphase. Now what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to connect to the device, which says the printer is now online. And I'm actually going to move the X stepper 10 steps and see what happens. So that looks good. Now I'm going to try the Y for 10 steps and see what happens. And that looks good as well. So I'm going to try 100. And then I'm going to try 100 for the X. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.